Grandos, you're fighting Javier Fortuna. Did you study his fight with Robert Easter? And tell me what you saw in that fight.
Really good fight. He did his thing. A lot of people thought, you know, Robert was going to, you know, walk through. Shout out to Robert Easter.
But Robert won the fight.
Robert won the fight. He did. It was a close fight. A lot of people were saying, you know, that Javier, you know, pulled off the upset. I watched it. I think Robert deserved the nod, but it was a tough task. Javier's very difficult, you know.
Southpaw
slick, awkward.
But he's a little guy. He moved up from 130.
Yeah.
135. Now he's coming to your territory.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe biting on too much. We don't know. We'll see.
We'll see next Saturday. Just gonna be prepared for whatever he got.
How long have you been in camp now? The fight came out of nowhere, it seems like.
I've been. There's a couple fights that actually fell off. Once again, more frustration for the Granados career. Just like fights coming in.
Who were you supposed to fight?
I was supposed to fight. We were working. They told me all types of names, but I mean, you know, they I said like two or three fights in the past.
Big names.
Four months, yeah. Big names. Shoot, we were sneaking on some good stuff, but it was like, you know, they're like, oh, we're gonna get you this. It's gonna happen. Up, and I'm like, yo, I'm like, dude, I've been in the gym 3-4 months. Like, come on, man. But
the fans love you. You have a great fan support.
Yeah, I do, and I appreciate that. That's why I always show love to my fans. I always show love to people I see out in the streets or people who ever notice me. It's still like, I love it. You know, I mean, I'm grinding. You know, I know. Like I said, I always say in my interviews and stuff, like, I don't. Obviously, you know, I got the record all messed up, and people try to come at me with that. But I'm like, you guys don't know what I've gone through and what I've had to grind. You know, I wasn't signed out of my amateur career. I had to sell tickets, I had to holler, and they had to get. I had to hold the job down all the time. It got to a point where I knew I was just as good as the best out there. I'm like, I gotta just start fighting everybody. And sure enough, now I got the recognition, and now I'm ready. You know, to really put a staple on the boxing world and just show them that, yeah, man, I'm here.
140 division, you have, of course, Jose Ramirez, the champion. Mm-hmm. Regis, who you talk smack to online. He talks smack to you online, but when you guys met, I thought you were homies since high school.
Yeah.
You guys were very, very friendly. I thought you were going to continue to talk from the internet.
I could have, but
the time or the place.
Not the time to play.
You're not fighting him anyway.
Not only that, it surprised me, too. I was like, oh, shit, I'm like, fucking Regis here. I said, what up? Like,
did you tell him online, the worst thing you told him?
He came at me because he Ruguru. He said, what'd he say? He said, oh, watch Ruguru bite the head off of El Tigre. So I know he's a New Orleans boy. I'm like, all right, well, watch El Tigre make jambalaya out of Ruguru. Yeah, bro, dude, I've been to New Orleans a couple times with my family. We love the food down there, love Cajun.
Mardi Gras?
Mardi Gras, I haven't been yet.
I gotta see if it's true what they say. I don't know if it's true.
We gotta see if it's, maybe we should go out there and see if it's the truth.
Okay, so let me ask you a couple of things. Canelo, FIFA is Danny Jacobs. What do you think?
Man, very good fight. You know what? Very good fight. I think that'll get him a lot of respect. I think that'll get him, That's a very interesting fight. That'd be one of the hottest fights in boxing.
Who does Triple G fight then if it's not Canelo?
Man.
Billy Joe Saunders? Billy Charlo?
Either of those. I mean, you know, it's all up to them. You know, there's a lot of talent in the middleweight division and in the junior middleweight division. So, yeah, it's exciting. I think boxing's going through a good time right now.
Have you gotten a call from Eddie Hearn yet?
I have not, no.
He had a big deal, $1 billion. What do you think of that?
Yeah, it's great, man. It's great. Good for him. It's good for boxing. I think it was Bob Arum who had said that, you know, like, it's good for boxing, you know, all different types of segues and different, you know, forms of income for boxers. And yeah, man, we're all, you know, just trying to make a living. And I mean, it's a great thing. You know, boxing's never going to die out. We're a legendary sport. And I think, yeah, it's a good time.
Adrien Broner gets a lot of flack. A lot of people criticize him. You were in camp with him. First of all, he's a very nice person, very cool, very chill. What impressed you about his boxing skills that people don't give him credit for?
He got heart and he got balls, man. Like, I mean, shoot, that fight with Jesse was a very exciting fight. Shout out to both of them. They're both my guys. They both beat me. Amateurs, Jesse beat me for the trials 15-13, and then Broner got the close decision. So they're my boys. Like, they
very close fights.
Yeah, they all were close fights. Either of them could have gone my way, and I know they know that. That's why we chop it up. You know, Jesse's been to Chicago, and I've hung out with him. Broner, like, we're boys. He'll hit me up,
okay.
You know.
So if they have a rematch, what do you think?
if they have a rematch, I mean, it's a good fight. We'll see what happens. Shoot, I'm trying to get a rematch. I'm one in too, you know? I mean, I feel like I beat Adrien, you know? And that's why I even called him, kind of gave him some flack. I'm like, bro, I mean, because he hurt Jesse. And I a lot of people thought he almost was going to get stopped. I'm like, hey, bro, you never had me hurt in my fight. I'm like,
what
I
did he say?
And he just kind of laughed it off. You know, that's my guy. I'm like, what's up, bro? I would have been fine with a draw. I'm like, yeah, y'all didn't have to give me that unnecessary L, but... It's, you know, it's just politics. And I mean, like I said, that's where I know I'm very vocal, and I kind of sometimes I don't care. I don't give a shit, like they say, where I'm like, I know I have enough marks on my record where I feel like they'll just keep throwing. If it's close, they'll just throw them to me. So I know, like with the Amir Imam fight where I had to take that fight, that's what I have to do. You know,
but you stopped him. He's a great fighter. And he was a KO cartel. I mean, knocking everybody out. And, so if you had a chance, you want Regis or do you want Jose Ramirez? If you had the opportunity.
Either or, I mean, I feel like they'll always give me the hardest way to the top. But, I mean, with the champion, obviously he got the title shot with Amir. Amir, you know, got the title shot before me. Ramirez beat him, but I stopped him. So it's like, come on, man, I feel like that's my belt.
All right, there you have it. Tell people where to follow you if they're watching.
Yeah, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, El Tigre AG. Shout out to Chicago, shout out to Cicero, Viva Mexico, ya sabes, vamos con todo.
And what do you tell AB if he's watching?
AB, what's up, dog?
He was training Rick Ross yesterday.
I seen that.
He got skills. Rick Ross is a pretty good dude.
I haven't got to see the video yet, but that was coming up on my YouTube. Yeah, definitely got to check that out.
There you have it, El Tigre, FacebookReport.com, Zekbach reporting. El Tigre del Norte, like the group.
El Tigre del Más Norte.
You know the song? The song about, what is it, the mule, the cow, the dog, Los Tres Animales.
Tres Animales. I would have to.
By Tigres El Norte. Look it up. Okay. They're smuggling drugs. They're three mules.
Oh, man. That's true. Trust me. You listen to any of their albums, it's just a straight how to do it. Like, how to.